Can my computer or signed-in account be hacked from the internet? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. This is actually a fairly common concern in a number of different forms. Here's the question that came up. Is it possible for hackers to hack an account that has not been logged out from the internet? Now, unfortunately, the question's a little bit ambiguous. There's a couple of different ways I could take it. For example, can hackers hack into my computer from the internet to access accounts that I've signed into? Or can hackers hack into my online accounts on the internet because I haven't signed out of the account on my computer? The good news is, regardless of how we interpret the question, both answers are basically no. But because there are never any absolutes when it comes to security, anything is possible. The true answer for both is that it is extremely unlikely. All right, let's take a look at the scenarios. Can they hack into your computer? If someone successfully hacked into your computer, then, well, yeah, they would have immediate access to any of the accounts you happen to be logged into at that time. But before you panic, let's take a look at what that hacker would have had to have done in order to make that happen. The very first thing that they would have to do is they'd have to breach your router. Your router acts as an incredibly powerful firewall, preventing unsolicited connections from the internet to any computer on your local network. Routers, honestly, are really underrated in this regard. They are a very, very powerful first line of defense. And regardless of how you've thought of it, if you have a router, in other words, you're sharing your internet connection between two or more computers, then you're done. You've got a great firewall. But then a hacker would also have had to have breached the Windows firewall. Windows firewall is honestly something we rarely think about these days, as it works fairly quietly in the background. While its history has certainly been spotty, the firewall built into Windows has come a long way and represents another significant layer of protection. While it's technically redundant in some ways with the firewall provided on your router, it's so unobtrusive that leaving it on is just a fine thing to do. And of course, they would then have to breach Windows itself. Even if hackers were able to bypass both firewalls that are standing in their way, they'd still have to find and leverage some kind of unpatched vulnerability in Windows itself before they could gain access to anything. Keeping Windows up to date, as well as keeping your security software up to date and having good habits, is your best protection in the unlikely events that anyone ever makes it this far. So, no, I just don't see it being likely at all. That's why I don't turn off my computer at night as protection against hacking. It's just not that big a threat. The other question, could they hack into your account online? Honestly, this one's even easier. There's nothing about being signed into an online account on your PC that makes hacking that account from somewhere else on the internet any easier. In fact, in theory, I suppose it could make it even a little harder. So let's say you're signed into an account on your PC. Now you go and sign into that same account on your mobile device or some other computer. You're instructed to approve that second sign-in on the first computer. Approving something on a machine they don't have access to is just not something a hacker has any hope of hacking. Now, admittedly, most sign-in techniques will let you say, I can't access another signed-in machine, but the alternatives offered are defected by your having been signed in the first place. So, once again, no. Your online account isn't at any greater risk because you stayed signed in on your PC. Okay, great. Hopefully, I've set your concerns to rest. But what about the real risks to your security? Well, first off, if you allow malware onto your machine, that malware can do anything. Your firewalls don't protect you if you explicitly download and run something malicious or open an attachment you shouldn't have. All bets are off when this happens. Having that malware gain access to your online accounts at that point might be the least of your concerns. Online accounts get hacked for a variety of reasons. Here are the most common mistakes to avoid. Phishing. You get an email claiming to be from some service you use, requesting that you take some action involving a link in the email. You click the link, you log in, and in doing so, you've just handed your online credentials to a hacker. Malware and keyloggers. As I mentioned above, once you've allowed it on your machine, malware can do anything, and one of those anythings is recording your keystrokes as you sign into your online accounts. Password reuse. Your account at Service A gets breached through no fault of your own, and your password there becomes known. Shortly thereafter, your account at Service B gets hacked because you use the same password in both places. And of course, poor password quality. You create easy-to-guess passwords, or you create short passwords that are easy to crack. In my opinion, these are the risks you should be paying attention to and ensuring that your own good habits protect you against. Like I said, for the record, I leave my primary computers on 24 hours a day, and they're all signed into a variety of accounts constantly. It's just not something I worry about. There is no such thing as perfection when it comes to security. Anything is possible. But it's really important to prioritize your efforts and focus on the things that really matter. Someone, somehow, reaching in from the internet seems really scary, and it's the stuff of movie lore. The common ways that bad things happen are much less exciting, but fortunately, much more in your control. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/185714. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.